Everybody awake? Yes, after hearing all these beautiful biological women, I was wondering where I'm lost. Actually, really from morning, I was getting tired. When gender came, when other issues came, it was only when brains came, it was only about male and female. I said, oh God, Lakshmi, you're nowhere. You're at the wrong way. But the fact is, and one thing which I believe, you know, which everybody said somewhere, femininity is universal. Why the men will feel bad? I didn't understand. Everybody, all the speakers said the men will feel bad. The men have to decide how much man they are, because the prakriti is nari. And I believe in that, because Srimad Bhagavad Gita, Krishna said, I am alone Purush, everybody, the whole nature is feminine. And that is the way what Lakshmi stands in front of you. For me, I come from an orthodox Brahmin family, born in Thane, next district to Mumbai. My mother was a badly brought up child and notorious girl from the Brahmin orthodox society. And we come from the eastern UP, and my parents also. And my father was thrown out of his house because he was notorious and he didn't follow the Brahmin clan. And I think so those things came into me. My mother said that once the teacher shouted at her, so she slapped the teacher and she came home. Then there were teachers appointed to teach her at her home. She come from that zamidar background. And my father was always with the thakurs, who were well-known gundas, and few were killed by the police and few went to become politicians. So my grandfather disowned him. Now Lakshmi, when I was born, my great-grandfather before I was born said that this to my mother, she will give birth to 7 children, 3 will survive, and among them the first so-called male child, you should give the name Lakshmi Narayan Tripathi. So Lakshmi was given the name. I came on the planet Earth. And as a child, I was a little bit sick child, and I was very pampered, very feminine. Right, I don't know when I discovered myself. That is, always people say, no, when did you realize? When did you feel you were different? I was never different. I was as normal as any biological woman or biological man. That is what space I have come to talk about. Because pre-British, before independence, or before the invasions of the Britishers, we had space. Our ancestors were quite smart enough to give space for people like us, or gays, or lesbians. Everybody had their own space. But now we have not, we don't even have the time, whether it's business. Why can't education could be given to this entire community and make them strong enough and use their manpower or their brain power to give so much of upliftment in the business, because we don't produce kids. So 9 months are saved that way. And then hardly we have heartbreaks. So, you know, so it hardly matters. But those pieces never there. I still remember, you know, when like, I was very small and people used to call me homo, gay. And then I decided to go and meet Ashok Rao Kavi, the well-known gay activist, you know, because one of my friends said, Lakshmi, you should meet him, you know, people call you abnormal. One of the aunties, I always had women who were quite elder to me as friends. And this color lipstick is of my Sangeeta auntie, why I was quite impressed. I used to go 3 o'clock in the night also, she used to come well dressed up. Yes, baby, what happened? She says, as a woman, you should be completely, you should understand the woman within you. So you were born woman. I discover my womanhood, the beautiful womanhood, and I enjoy it. And I love it. And that is my power. We say patriarchal society, we are foolish because we don't understand what is the power of woman. Ask me, at times at many meetings, I go showing my cleavage and my half of the thing is done. And I have not to bother about anything in this world. But I'm confident about myself. Like who? Because life, when I decided my sexuality with the gay community, they said, she's not me. Even a blind person can say she's not gay. She's something else. So I was outcasted from the gay community. Drag queen community dress roughly as girl in parties and stuff. And I used to feel no means, like, my life is not only parties, to go in the party and dress up like a woman, or have 10 boyfriends, or have love affairs. That I was not. I was a woman completely, like a complete Indian Bharatiya Nari, learning classical dance with all the odds. And so once I met, in my life there was quite ups and downs. It's like I had everything. My parents gave me the best of the thing. But the problem was my sexuality. Whom to tell? Men felt that I was a toy which could be used according to their fancies and to be left. I was abused as a child once or twice, and I learned to say no. If you do it, I'll tell my parents. But I never told my parents. In a reality show, my parents came to know because they were sitting in the same, that was Sach Ka Samna, telling the truth, the US based. So, that, and my parents never asked me also. My father is no more, but that time also my father never turned and asked who, what. I love them. Because I had one strong thing, that my parents accepted the child as the child is. My father say, when we don't throw away a handicapped child, my child's sexuality is different. Any educated parent won't go and see in a bedroom of the son or the daughter what they're doing. So even I'm not interested what Lakshmi is doing in her bedroom. For me, Lakshmi is my child. And that's how even my mother also said, and that's how they fought the odd even in the village. Today, like I, Saloni, when she spoke to me first time, I was in my village, dressed up like that, roaming around and talking to her on the phone. And somebody called me uncle, somebody calls me auntie, somebody calls me Didi. I said, you can call me anything. I'm a Hijra, I'm a transgender woman for myself. Because that is what I am. I decide what I am, not the society. Why I should allow the society to decide for me? Who are you? Because I'm living my own life. And I have a life, a complete right of life with dignity. And nobody can, like Lokmanya Tilak had said, Swaraj is my birthright. So my life with dignity is my birthright in which I shall have it. So Ashok Rao Kavi said to me, I was in fourth standard vacations, and fifth standard I reached Maheshwari Gardens, if people know in Mumbai. That was the paradise of the gay world. And I went and said, that Ashok, the world calls me abnormal and I like men, is really something problem with me? Then, and I was a child with a teddy bear, and Ashok said, baby, you're very normal. The world around you is abnormal. Study, what you like, dance, study dance. And I exactly did that, you know, like a horse. And I did it. Afterwards, I was into model coordination. I wanted to be a quota son. I say, if I was a woman, I would have a big quota, and I would have danced and made all the men, right from the prime minister to the president, to come to my quota and watch me and play the tunes. So, but that was unlucky. I was not a biological woman, so I said, fine. But I danced in bars. I danced in bars for 4 years, 11 months. My parents came to know, they thrashed me. They said, our child can't be a bar dancer. But then in that process also, I learned about many communities where these women came from. That they didn't have an option, that with Rajan, Atvanjia, these all women in that industry were all maternal clans, which nobody, like we sophisticated people, don't want to talk about. Why? It doesn't bother us. We are doing our business, we are having crores of rupees, fine. There we don't, that social responsibility, how much we live upon. I'm good, I'm speaking at the Indian School of Business, where every entrepreneur has a social responsibility which they don't fulfill. Very few of them do it. And it is sad in a country like us, where there are so many communities which are not even addressed. For example, transgender and Hijra community, even doctors don't want to touch you. Educated doctors. I'm an educated person, I'm a good PR. I wish there 20 entrepreneurs become, and once if you all reach to success, call me, I'll be your PR. I'll do your work. But that guts won't come in people. I know who's and who's not in this country, but who will give employment to transgender women or a hijra woman? Nobody. People talk very big. I still remember when I was like child, when I used to walk on the street, I had to walk like that first. Then later on I decided, no, Lakshmi, you should respect your own self. Then I started walking with the straight head. But that confidence which built in me gave me the time to establish Dai Welfare Society, which became the Southeast Asia's first transgender hijra organization. And there also we had to prove, because people were dying with HIV/AIDS, and I went to Mumbai District AIDS Control Society and asked Dr. Alka Gokti, who was the project director, that we need project. She was shocked. She said, hijra is matlab. But she was a very brave woman. Best of the things are done with women for our community. And I really want to applaud all the women who have done this good. Please. Whether you like it or not, but I like it. Yes. So Dr. Alka Gokti is one pioneers who said, I trust you all. So we had from the president to the pune, all hijras. They said like, and that was fun. Office mein, what you told about, you know, how office thing. Office mein bhi kabhi bhi, whenever you felt you can clap like hijras. Whenever you feel you can put your lipstick. Whenever you feel your hair is not done properly, just tie your hairs. They had all the liberties. They were educated. Some had done commerce graduation. Some had done 12th. Somebody did 10th. And we told that we will take training from the Mumbai District AIDS Control Society. But the government was very spectacle how it will work and how not. So they gave us 6 months project. And later on, it became the Nobel project across India as an example. Later on, I had clashes with my own community because, I don't know, always I have been outcasted. With the hijra community, it's a pyramid. And with the, because there is no system what like people like us. If you go once to this community, the society which I'm talking to doesn't has any space to take us back. So people get exploited within the community. So this tag, once I get a tag of a hijra, I don't have a U-turn to go back to you. And that's sad. Today I had that tag, but still I had my parents' house. I had my sister's house. I had my brother's house to go back, or my brother to just stand next to me. Nobody can say anything to Lakshmi. But there are so many brothers or sisters, like gay, homosexual, what it is. It is for them, not for you. As a society, we Indians say we are very cultured, quote unquote. But the biggest thing what we talk is always about sex and sexuality. And we are not ready to give about their education about it. We want to know that whom she is dating, or what the, if that boy is effeminate, with whom he is doing what, or if that hijra is doing that, how beautiful that hijra is, or whatever, you know. There are always about it, but not ready to accept it. Why? Are we so hypocrite? One thing I learned, I'm a duck. You can pour water. I said it in my Mumbai TEDx also. I'm a duck. You can pour water. You can say any shit to me. It doesn't matter. I choose to hear, I choose to speak. And that's how I attained. I still remember when I entered UN building, Manhattan, as a United Nations Civil Society Task Force member and all this big label, and I was shocked that the Asia Pacific Sex Workers Network, they voted, 11 people were voted for this, and I happened to be one. And I said, I never did sex work. Said, and Andrew Hunter and Ruth, they said, bitch, you have done everything beyond sex work, and you are going to go and speak about sex workers and HIV/AIDS and human rights and sexual minority. This is your job. And I said, okay. There are 500 pages, all everything which you have to read, the whole, what we say, draft which has come. I said, yes, I'll read that, you know. So I got spanking on my butt many times to be a social worker, a responsible social worker. But when I entered the UN building and I was going to the assembly hall, and when I saw the Indian flag and I touched it, that was a moment when I felt, Lakshmi, you have achieved something in life. Because that was, I would be the first hijra over here who has come and touched this transgender, my own flag. But does that flag people, whoever comes under that flag, even care about us? No. Very few. Tamil Nadu government has done something. Now recently, before coming over here, on the 29th, yes, Maharashtra Women and Child Minister, Varsha, she made an announcement from such a podium that we in Maharashtra, the Women and Child Ministry will take responsibility for the transgender hijra population and the sex workers, which is fine. The problem is that people talk about rehabilitation, people talk about many things, and you tag the people. We as society, we tag them and we don't allow them to come into the society. And that is in our brains. For me, I still remember yesterday who had come to pick me up, that handsome guy. What is his name? Pratik. While coming, I asked Pratik, in your life, it would be for the first time you are speaking to a hijra and sitting next to a hijra. And he said, yes. I said, that is the taboo. That is the taboo when people, when I see now Lakshmi is famous. I came on television. I'm here. I'm there. So now it's a celebrity status. But the problem is that I still relate myself to that hijra who is doing sex work in the night, who is begging. And this is what not we want. We are paying a cost. You know what is that cost? Of living a life which is not hypocritical. We are living a life what we want and what true we are. And that is a life which every hijra chooses to live, or a transgender woman. And then what you get in return is that you're not a hypocrite, but you're a big stigma. Every eye will have a question mark when they look at you. Why they are like that? Why they can't do anything? Why they can't work? Why they beg? But did, as a society or a social responsibility, anybody thought about it? No. We are thinking. So that's why we have filed a case in Supreme Court and we are fighting with them. And now Supreme Court recently said that sex workers, whether male, female, or transgender, or hijras, to the Indian Oil, they wrote, why don't you give them petrol pumps? When you have to rehabilitate people or look into people's issue, you have to see to the standard what they're earning. Shaving machines or anything, what do you think, what socially one woman can come out or one hijra can come out? It's not that. It's all about livelihood. As entrepreneurs, we, it's not only Lakshmi, we, my whole community looks upon the school, individuals, speakers like you who can create different in our life with your broad horizon of your understanding about sexuality. Sexuality is to yourself. Society tags you. I deny to take that tag because I said, I'm not the crowd. I will be the face in the crowd. And I always did that. I never cared. I want to wear a maroon dark lipstick, I'll wear it. I want to wear a backless stuff, I'll wear it. Give a damn, whoever wants to think whatever. And I lived, and that is what life has given me back, my own position. I have only one dream, you know, one sentence which I have lived my life with, that I shall perish, not my name. It shall be carved in the marbles to be remembered. And with this note, I say goodbye to all of you.